हेलो एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू गाइस? आई होप एवरीवन ऑफ यू आर फाइन एंड रिवाइजिंग योर पोर्शंस एवरी डे सिंस वी हैव कंप्लीटेड आवर कोर्स. ऑल यू हैव टू डू इज रिवाइज एंड अटेंड दिस पीवाईक्यूज सेशन वेर यू विल सॉल्व ऑल द क्वेश्चंस वन बाय वन फ्रॉम ऑल द ईयर्स, स्पेशली पास्ट 10 ईयर्स वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस पर्टिकुलर सीरीज. ओके, सो आई रियली होप यू गाइज आर रिवाइजिंग वेल. सो इन द कमेंट सेक्शन लेट मी नो हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू गाइज आर रिवाइजिंग डेली. ओके, हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू आर रिवाइजिंग डेली? ओके, यू गाइज नो मी, आई एम योर एजुकेटर सरान्या एंड दिस इज गुरुमंत्र यूट्यूब चैनल. आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू द सेशन. सो दिस इज अवर पी वाई क्यूज डिटेल्ड एनालिसिस सीरीज एंड टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन गेट बायोटेक्नोलॉजी 2015 पेपर. ओके, 2015 पेपर वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चंस. सो इन दिस सीरीज वी हैव प्लान टू डू पास 10 ईयर क्वेश्चंस, ऑल कंप्लीट सॉल्यूशंस वी आर गोइंग टू डू इन दिस. ओके ओके, सो द रूल्स यू नो, टोटली यू विल हैव 60 मार्क्स, विच मीन्स 30 क्वेश्चंस यू विल हैव. फॉर एवरी करेक्ट आंसर यू विल गेट 2 मार्क्स एंड इफ योर आंसर इज रॉन्ग -1 मार्क. ओके, सो कीप योर नोटबुक एंड पेन रेडी सो दैट यू कैन राइट योर स्कोर्स देयर. ओके, फॉर एवरी क्वेश्चन यू विल बी गेटिंग 1 मिनट टू रीड, अंडरस्टैंड एंड आंसर द क्वेश्चन. ओके, सो बी वेरी हॉनेस्ट विथ योर सेल्फ बिकॉज दिस इज अ मॉक टेस्ट टाइप ऑफ सीरीज. यू आर गोइंग टू टेस्ट योर सेल्फ लाइक हाउ मच यू हैव अंडरस्टूड, वट इज योर लेवल, हाउ मच यू आर लैगिंग, एवरीथिंग यू कैन understand from these series. Okay, so that if you are lagging a little bit behind you can catch up now also. There is still time guys, so don't worry. So after the test is over what you can do is total the scores, okay, and put it in the comment section. Don't be lazy guys. Okay, I am seeing that very few of you only posting the scores, not many. So I would like to mention it that you put the scores in the comment section because you have to do that in order to improve yourself. Okay, if you are scoring less, no problem, put it in the comment section. Okay, that itself will be a driving force for you to score more marks in the next session. Okay, so keep that driving force alive. So give it your best shot guys, all the very best for the test. Okay, let's start the test. So few questions from previous year paper, that is 2016, was left, which I have added included in this session. Okay, that is what is happening. Few questions, like 3-4 questions are getting missed because we are only concentrating up to 30 questions, right? So those questions I am actually adding in the next session. So some of you ask me whether I'll be taking aptitude. Aptitude I have planned like a separate series. If time permits, we will do all the aptitude in the PYQs. Maths we are not doing. Okay, so maths we are not doing. Aptitude we will try to do. And after this PYQ session is over, I will try to have few more numerical doses so that we can complete some like 5-6 years numericals. Okay, okay, so let's see the question. A variety of genetic elements are used in the transgenic plant research. Match the genetic elements column 1 with their corresponding source column 2. Okay, so the correct answer for this question is option D. Okay, option D is the correct answer. So P is ubiquitin 1 promoter. Okay, that will match with Z maize, that is a transgenic plant research. Next is NOS transcriptional terminator, which is option 1, Agrobacterium tumefaciens. Next you have bar selection marker gene, that is present in Streptomyces hygroscopicus. Next you have Gus reporter gene, that is for E. coli. Okay, next question. Okay, so the correct answer for this question is option C. Okay, this is also match the following question. You can solve this question with one single option itself. Okay, R, you see R, which is X-linked inheritance. Hemophilia is an X-linked inheritance disease. If you know that, you can solve everything else. Okay, R4 is only present in option C. Okay, let's see one by one. Autosomal recessive inheritance, that is P. It has cystic fibrosis. Next is autosomal dominant inheritance, that is Huntington chorea disease. Next you have R, X-linked inheritance for hemophilia. Okay, and you have Y-linked inheritance for hairy ears. Okay, next question. Okay, find the incorrect combination. A is surface immunoglobulins, that is for B cell receptor antigen. B is affinity maturation isotype switching, that is wrong. Okay, C is Fc regions of antibodies, that is involved in complement protein binding. D is spleen, which is a secondary lymphoid organ and it does not have any connection with the lymphatic system. Okay, so B is the incorrect option. Next question. Which of the following statements correct for antigen activated effector T cells? Okay, CD4 plus cells make contact with the macrophages and stimulate their microbicidal activity. That is correct. CD4 plus cells make contact with B cells and stimulate them to differentiate. That is also correct. CD8 plus cells make contact with B cells. That is wrong. They cannot make contact with B cells. So R is definitely wrong. Okay. CD8 plus cells make contact with the virus infected cells and kill them. That is true. Okay. So P, Q and S is the correct answer. Option C. Which of the following statement regarding the G protein is incorrect? Okay, GDP is bound to G protein in the resting stage, that is inactive stage, that is correct. GTP bound alpha subunit cannot reassemble with beta gamma dimer, that is also correct, because if GDP is bound to alpha subunit, it can reassemble. If GTP is bound, then it cannot reassemble. All G proteins are trimeric, that's not true. Activation of G protein may result in the activation or inhibition of the target enzymes, that is also correct. So the incorrect statement from this is option C. Okay, in animal cell culture, a carbon dioxide rich environment atmosphere in the incubator chamber is used to maintain the culture pH between 6.9 and 7.4. Which of the following statement is correct? Okay, if carbon dioxide is more, which means there will be high concentration of bicarbonate buffer in the solution. That is the statement. Okay, so A is the correct answer. Next question. Okay, so you have to choose true or false for the following statements. Okay, so P is higher cell densities can be achieved using microcarriers, that is correct. So P is true, which means option C and D you can eliminate. Microcarriers increase the surface area for cell growth, that is also true. Q is also true. So you can eliminate option A also. Now you can see only option B is correct. Okay, microcarriers are used for both anchorage and non-anchorage dependent cells. That's not true. Microcarriers are used for anchorage dependent cells. Absence of surface charge on microcarriers enhances the attachment of cell. That is also false because opposite charge attracts. So there should be some kind of a charge in that. Okay, so P and Q are true, R and S are false. So option B is the correct answer. Okay, which one of the following complement proteins is the initiator of the membrane attack complex? So the correct answer is option D, C5b. C5b, C6, C7, C8 and C9 forms the membrane attack complex. Next question. Okay, Lewindahl paradox is related to, this paradox is related to protein folding. Okay, I'll explain you what it is. So the protein folding, or also called as Lewindahl paradox, states that it would not be possible in a physically meaningful time to a protein to reach the native conformation, that is the functional conformation, by a random search of enormously large number of possible structure. It simply means that you have a linear structure of protein, that is primary structure. Okay, as it folds, there are several ways it can fold. Okay, but one particular folding will give it a native functional form, which is stable and least in energy. So how will protein know how it has to fold? So that is called as Lewindahl paradox. We will not be able to find out which particular conformation the protein has to fold, because we do not know that. For that particular purpose only, to solve this problem, computational approaches have been come so that we can understand what are the different ways in which protein folding can occur. So protein folding in nature has the ability to fold within a second, even less than a second, like in millisecond. Okay, in a millisecond it can fold to the native form, but we cannot find that structure if we are doing some kind of computational work by itself. Okay, it will take a lot of time for us, but yes, we can predict that using computational approaches. Next question. Okay, which one of the following is a second generation genetically engineered crop, that is golden rice? Okay, C. Next question. Okay, based on the heavy chain, which of the following antibodies has multiple subtypes? So the correct answer is IgG. Next question. Okay, the cytokinetic organelle in plant cell is. So, cytokinetic organelle means cytokinesis, division of cytoplasm. So, for that particular purpose, the correct answer for this question is phragmoplast. Okay. So, you can see here phragmoplast, which is involved in the cytokinesis. Plastid, okay, here other options also will explore. Proplastid is nothing but a progenitor cell, okay, so that is involved in the differentiation into several types of cells like chromoplast, chloroplast, leucoplast, elaioplast and all. And next you have is, okay, chromoplast also we saw, which comes under this category only. Next you have centriole so are present in these centrosomes. Okay, from that only spindle fiber arises. Okay, next question. Anergy refers to unresponsiveness to antigens. Okay, C is the correct answer. Next question. Okay, ABO blood group antigens in humans are differentiated from each other on the basis of glycoproteins. So D is the correct answer. Okay, which one of the following organism used for the determination of phenol coefficient of a disinfectant? So, phenol coefficient of a disinfectant is a test to see if a disinfectant is worthy or not, whether it will work or not. And for that test, we will be using the microorganism Salmonella typhi. Okay. So, phenol coefficient test. So, this method is used for evaluation of the effectiveness of the disinfectants. Okay. For this, Staphylococcus aureus or Salmonella typhi can be used for the testing. So, dilution of the phenol and experimental disinfectant. Okay. So, phenol will be your standard, and whatever disinfectant you are going to test it, you're going to have it in the diluted concentration, and you're going to incubate it for 20 to 37 degrees Celsius for 3 days. So calculated by dividing the dilution of test disinfectant by the dilution of the phenol that disinfect under specified conditions. That is, if you do this, you will be able to find out if a particular disinfectant is effective or not. So that test is phenol coefficient test. Okay, which of the following amino acids has the high probability, that is highest probability to be found on the surface of a typical globular protein in aqueous environment? A very simple logic. If a protein or especially an amino acid has to be present on the surface in which is in contact with the aqueous environment, then it should be polar in nature. So the correct answer is option C, arginine. Next question. Okay, which of the following is not a product of denitrification in Pseudomonas? Okay, so option D is the correct answer for this question. Next question. Which one of the following feature is not required in a prokaryotic expression system? So you need origin of replication, you need selectable markers, you need ribosome binding site, but you do not need CMV promoter. Okay. Next question. Production of monoclonal antibodies by hybridoma technology requires splenocytes. From that only you will get B cells. So A is the correct answer. Next question. Okay, which of the following is incorrect about a typical apoptotic cell? So C is the wrong option because membrane potential does change during apoptosis. Okay. Next question. Okay, match the following in group 1 with group 2. Okay, so A is the correct option, cyanogen bromide, carboxyl side of methionine, that is C terminal of methionine, it will cut. Next you have O iodosobenzoate, okay, Q, that is for carboxyl side of tryptophan, which means it will cut the C terminal of tryptophan. Next you have hydroxylamine. That will cut asparagine glycine bonds. Next you have 2-nitro-5-thio-cyanobenzoate, that is S4. Okay, amino side of cysteine, that is N terminal of cysteine, it will cut. Next question. Thank you. Okay, which of the following relations holds true for the specific growth rate of a microorganism in the death phase? So, in the death phase, the growth rate will be less than zero. So, B is the correct answer. Next question. How many different protein sequences of 100 residues can be generated using 20 standard amino acids? Okay, so for this type of questions which we have done in previous sessions, there's a simple formula. Okay, possibilities, power, length. So 20 amino acid is the possibility, power length is 100 residues. So 20 power 100 is the correct answer. Next question. In DNA sequencing reactions, using the chain termination method, the ratio of DDNTPs to DNTPs should be. So usually the ratio between DDNTPs to DNTP is 1:100. So when you divide 1 by 100, you will get 0.01. So which is less than 1. So B is the correct answer. Next question. Which of the following graphs represents the uncompetitive inhibition? So in uncompetitive inhibition, you will have parallel graphs. Okay, you can simply remember up, U for uncompetitive, P for parallel, up. Also, okay, so A is the correct answer. Next question. So in the PYQ session we have done so far, I have taught you how to find the primers for the DNA sequence. It's very simple, okay? You just have to match the sequence and find, okay? For the first strand, which is from 5 dash to 3 dash direction, you can see the primer should be from 5 dash to 3 dash direction. That is complementary to this region, complementary to this region, okay? So that will be your R from here. And for this 3 dash to 5 dash, here you should have a 5 dash to 3 dash complementary strand that will be like a primer. That is your P. So P and R are the correct answer. Okay, sorry, P and S. Okay, because here you can see T is there. Okay, so T is there. So the 5 dash strand will start with A. Okay, that's why A T. C C C G T A T, that is S. Okay, so P and S will be the correct answer. Sorry for the mistake, I told R. Okay, it's not R, it's S. Just see the complementary sequence and that will be the answer. Next question. So this particular question we have seen in theory. Okay, we have learned this really well in theory. So I really hope all of you get correct answer for this question, especially I stressed so much on the point that you should remember this, you should remember this, because this question will be coming very often in the exams. So it is a that type of a question. So, I hope you guys get it correct. Okay, so the correct answer for this question is option C. Next question. Okay, so the correct answer for this question is option B. Okay, you can simply answer this question with two particular option. Colchicine, you know, colchicine that is used for inhibiting microtubule polymerization. Okay, so Q6, okay, that is actually present in two options A and B. So you can have it. Next is methotrexate, which is a very common drug that is useful in the inhibition of dihydrofolate reductase, that is DHFR. So S5. So B is your correct answer. Okay, next is R, etoposide, that is for inhibition of DNA replication. And next is paclitaxel, that is P, that is for your microtubule depolymerization inhibition. Okay. Next question. It's a very easy question. You should be able to answer it immediately. ओके, सो द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑप्शन बी. ओके बी. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. ओके मैच द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड द फर्मेंटेड प्रोडक्ट इन ग्रुप टू. ओके वेरी सिंपल. ओके द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑप्शन डी. ओके ल्यूकोनोस्टॉक मेसेंटेरॉइड्स. ओके दैट इज फॉर डेक्स्ट्रिन. नेक्स्ट इज राइजोपस ओराइजे. ओके राइजोपस ओराइजे दैट इज योर लैक्टिक एसिड. ओके नेक्स्ट इज ग्लूकोनोबैक्टर सबऑक्सीडेंस that is sorbose, streptomyces oliváceus that is cobalamin. okay so the correct answer is option d. that's all guys, our test is over. all you have to do now is total your scores and put it in the comment section. okay put it in the comment section and improve yourself every single day in every single test. okay all the very best to all of you. So you can like, share and subscribe. Also comment about your experience in our videos present in the YouTube channel Gurmantra Shikshaka Granth. If you have any further queries, you can contact us either through mail or you can call us. Thank you so much guys and have a nice day.